I've told you before, this is your last chance. Do us a favour and take a look at your father's book. Get Mr. White eliminated.
Can I help you?
Yes, you can. I've heard about you.
Oh, really? If that's true, you'll know not to sit down then.
Ah, but that's precisely why I need to sit here, you see. I've been told I need to look after myself, and my father was always drilling into me the rules about life. And do you know what he used to say?
No.
He said that when you get given a job, you need to see it through no matter what. So, when I get a phone call, or someone tells me to follow through on the job, I like to get it done as quickly and as painlessly as possible.
Do you even know why you've been asked to do what you're doing?
Well, that doesn't matter. You see, I've been paid handsomely for this. You're quite a big payday. Come on, we're both professionals here.
Well, what if I told you I could give you a bigger payday? Beyond what you've been paid for this.
Wait a minute. What are you talking about? You don't have that kind of money.
But I will.
Don't try anything wise.
If you're interested, put that away and we'll talk. Have you seen this man?
Nope. Should I?
Well, he's the man that everything goes through. His hands make the world go round. He's the man that really says how your life is and how it's going to run.
What can killing this man get me?
Oh, we don't just kill him. We just simply need to go and see him. And make sure that all the money that he gives out is into their pockets.
So, we just get this man to give us all the money from the boss?
Just so happens, there's a delightful man now. We've got a limited window here, and it could get messy. So, are you going to keep taking the boss's orders and stop me from taking this money he owns? Or are you going to follow me?
I have a question. Why go to all this trouble for some money?
Let's just say, I'm done taking orders. Bring those. Listen, Murray, how old are you?
That's not important. Can we just keep an eye on this person so we don't lose sight of where we're going?
I know where we're going. Late 80s, eh? You know, wasn't that different back then from what it is today? Believe it or not. There was a song they used to play on the radio. I remember it because I was working this protection job at the time. Nothing special, just security details. Night shift up in Albion Street. You know where that is, right? Near the City Halls. The old fruit market. Anyway, there was this guy called Dennis. The Dennis was an alcoholic. He used to show up every night. Just outside, you know the bit when you drive in and pay? He'd be there, outside, every night, on our property. Setting up all his gear and going through his routine.
You mean, eh?
Busking. You know, singing. He was a kind of Bobby Gillespie looking kind of guy with a long hair and a long jacket, you know? I sees him this one night just as I'm walking in, starting my shift. It's not even 7 o'clock yet, and I can tell straight away that he's already had a few. He's playing a song with that band Poison, you know that? Every cowboy has a sad, sad song, and every rose has its thorn. I remember that. Ordinarily, I'd have phoned the coppers. They'd have came and booked them for the umpteenth time and moved them on. And hey presto, everybody's happy. My gaffer's happy and I can finish my shift in peace. But I know if I phone them this time, he's going to get lifted. He's going to get jailed. So I walks right up to him. I can see this look in his eye, you know, a kind of a nervousness. So I decide to take pity on the poor bastard. Finish up tonight, I tell him. That's the last I ever want to see you near this car park. In fact, I don't ever want to see your ugly face in this street again. Do you understand? Because if you don't, that guitar isn't the only thing that's going to get broken. I'll be phoning the police again, but this time they'll be coming for me because I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. I'm going to hit you with such and such. You know the routine.
It's a warning.
Of course. I'm just trying to do the right thing here. Anyway, later on that night, as I'm locking up, I hear this heart-wrenching cry. Turns out, his ex had been working in the restaurant just across from the car park. And the bald Dennis, he's been stalking her, you know, trying to get her attention. He's decided, tonight's the night. So I've ran round the corner. Just as I get there, there's a big crowd already gathered. Right in the middle is Dennis. He's down on his hands and knees, and he's wailing. I mean, this boy is letting it all out. And lying right beside him is this poor girl. And she's gone, just like that. All because of me, because of my stupid mistake. See, she'd come out of the restaurant arm in arm with another guy. Turns out later, it's just a co-worker, there wasn't even anything happening. But the bald Dennis is lying in the gutter and he sees this. Everything goes red, just like the rose. And I decided that night, I'll never make that mistake again.
That's a heartfelt story, Mr. White, really, but what are we doing standing about here? As you adequately put it, we have a job to do, to finish.
Don't you worry, I've not forgot about the job, all the money.
home long enough to know if I ever was a child. I was tied up like a boat, unbuttoned like a coat, set free for a while.